unicorn, so today I will be doing my Flareon-inspired look. Lots of fiery, bright colors, and this was so much fun to create. So if you want to know how I got this look, just stay tuned. So the first thing I'm going to do is apply a eyeshadow primer all over my lid. I'm just using the Urban Decay eyeshadow primer in the original formula. And I'm just applying this all over my lid, up to the brow, and just blending it out with my finger. Using the Beads Cosmetics Spoiled Eyeshadow Palette, I'm going to be taking these top two yellow shades, and I'm going to mix those two together to give me the perfect kind of fiery yellow. I'm sorry that these clips are so bright. I'm trying out a new system, so please bear with me. Don't know why it was so bright, but you get to see how awfully pale I really am. Now going into the Kat Von D Star Studded Palette, I'm going to be getting the color Mandala, which is a medium orange with a slight red tone and some really pretty shimmer. I will be using a medium fluffy flat brush, and I will apply it on the center of my lid, blending into the yellow. And I'm going to bring it up past my crease just a little bit so that when my eye opens, you can actually see the color. Hooded eye problems. Now going into the Kat Von D Mi Vida Loca Remix Palette, I'm going to be taking the two red shadows, and I'm going to mix those together to get the perfect red. I'm using a tapered blending brush to give me a little bit more control over blending and blend into the orange. I'm going to keep everything kind of cat eye shaped, just so we can get that kind of sassy, fierce look for Flareon, because we all know Flareon is sassy and proud of it. Now to help the colors blend into my skin, I'm using this light brown shade as a transition color. You can put it before or after, I kind of forgot, so I'm putting it in now. So I'm using that to blend the harsh lines into my skin tone, and I'm using a really fluffy brush for this, and I'm sorry it's kind of out of focus, I fail, and I'm just going back over and touching up any of the colors that need to be touched up, and actually bringing it a little bit higher than I had originally had it. Again, hooded eye problems, so. Now taking those same colors that I had previously on the top lid, I'm going to be adding those on the lower lash line to mimic the top, and I'm going right by the lash line and doing the yellow, the orange, and the red, again keeping it very cat eye shaped. Now going into the Urban Decay Amarimosa palette, I'm going to be using the color Skimp, and I'm going to apply that as my brow highlight. I haven't drawn my brows on yet, but I will, and they will be kind of short and spiky, so I want something that kind of blends the brown that I had used earlier. And then using the BH Cosmetics Felt Tip Liner, I will be drawing a pretty thick wing and a sharp cat eye, and I have to say this liner has become my quick go-to. It's so long-lasting, and it does not want to come off, even with makeup remover. So I'm kind of impressed. BH Cosmetics, you guys were cool. You guys are amazing. So I highly suggest you grab this if you're looking for a long-lasting waterproof liner. Now I'm using the Wet n Wild Fergie liner in Little Black Dress, and I'm putting it on my lower waterline just to give it a smokier, darker appearance. So while off camera, I added a wig and my eyebrows along with the Urban Decay Perversion Mascara, which I'm like in love with, you guys. My eyebrows are pretty straight, and just put on a red wig. Now for the cheeks, I'm going to be using the Sleek 3x3 palette. And I'm going to mix the two orange shades. I know they look white, but I'm sorry for the super bright footage. But I'm going to be adding that on the apples of my cheeks. I already did my entire face off camera as well. And then using from Corpse Cosmetics, the Siren's Glow in Eros. I will be applying that on the high points of my face, such as my cheekbones, the center of my nose, my forehead, chin, non-existent cupid's bow. You know the drill. And then for lips, I'm going to be using the Kat Von D Agogo Liquid Lipstick, and it's just a really bright orangey red. It looks hella orange, but it does have a bit of a red tone to it, so I'm using that for my lips and just applying that. And that is the finished look. I really hope you guys enjoyed this look, and thank you for requesting Flareon, and I really had a lot of fun being fierce and fabulous. So I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you did, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and thumbs up the video, and also hit that little bell below so you can be notified of every single upload, and you will not miss a single video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I love you guys, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye!